Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
My name is Sharon Randall, and I'm honored to be here this evening to welcome all of you to the dedication ceremony and celebration of Camp Road Middle School's new building and grounds. Those of us who get to work here or attend school here on this spacious campus are daily reminded of its beauty and its capacity and capability of providing unique class spaces both inside and out. This is the kind of space that brings a smile to our faces and encourages communication and laughter. It is interesting to experience how much a physical space inspires positive interactions, and we are thankful we get to be here. We hope that you enjoy being part of our celebration today and leave tonight also inspired by this beautiful space. I want to thank Margaret Downs, our chorus director, for her detailed work organizing the songs we're going to hear tonight sung by Camp Road students. We also appreciate our PE teachers, Ms. Courtney Dolan and Mr. Brian Duffy, for all their hard work ensuring that our media and sound equipment worked appropriately. I could go on thanking so many people, both inside our school, at the district level, our parents, our community members. You help us daily, and you have since we moved into this building, and we appreciate your support greatly. I have the distinct honor right now of introducing 9 unique Camp Road students who will be leading us in the Pledge of Allegiance. These are the same students who led the Pledge of Allegiance at the groundbreaking ceremony 2 years ago when they were sixth graders. Students, as I call your name, please come in and line up for us. The students are Ava Grace Lucky, Lauren Perucci, Ruby Windham, Elaine Chin, Joe Patterson, Karan Cromwell, Braxton Cypress, Anya Podolsky, and Ezra Victor, who cannot be with us tonight. I will now turn the program over to these students.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
It's exciting to be at Camp Road Middle School this year. It's wonderful to have all the space and new materials. Our teachers are very excited. Our kids are excited to be here. And it's a great opportunity to grow into the space. We actually have one or two classrooms that are not being used at the moment. And we anticipate filling those quickly as this community grows. We're very fortunate to have a huge field on the back side of our building that this community fought for. So we have access to a beautiful track area, outside football field. This is such a beautiful space. It re-energizes our adults when they come in every day, and our students are excited to come and learn in this environment.
I believe that combining James Island Middle School and Fort Johnson Middle School into one middle school, Camp Road Middle School, was certainly in the best interest of our community and our school community. What I can tell you about the new Camp Road Middle School campus is a beautiful, state-of-the-art facility. It's 137,000 square feet. It has 9 beautiful science labs that are approximately 1,200 square feet. A beautiful, beautiful gym that's 9,500 square feet that was designed very similar to the old Fort Johnson Middle School gym that was on this campus. Another asset is that we have a 7,000 square foot cafeteria. It has an outdoor dining area suitable for 60 kids to eat outdoors. And also we now have what I will call a performing arts wing. We have a separate band, strings, and chorus room.
Everyone loves kind of the way the school is laid out in something of an E above. You've got academic wings that keep each grade level really in their own area. They're tied together closely, but they're each in little small compartments. As far as the spaces, no one comes through this media center without just being jaw agape and just saying, wow, wow, wow. There's a window wall that's beautiful here and places for folks to set up tables right in front of the glass and look out. So even though we had our challenges getting here, we're so very proud of what we got in the end and really proud to have our kids here. I live right down the road and it's a beautiful thing for us to look at.
Just to have a community middle school, we're not looking at any division, like it's one community and one great middle school. It really, I feel like, brought everybody together. It's a family school and it's a community school. And it's really perfect for us.
It's nice to have a school that is brand new to all of us. When we combined schools, we had a little bit of old school, new school mentality, and now we have one big community center that belongs to all of us.
We are such a tight community. The teachers love our school. We love our families, and to finally be in a building that is worth celebrating just means a lot. This building is here because Mr. Parler dreamed of a combined middle school and he shepherded the project through every detail. I bet he can tell you where every outlet is in this building. And the result is that teachers have functional, fabulous classrooms and we have the spaces that we need for every kind of activity. So yes, this is just a dream for our community.
I jumped up so quickly, I think I'm next on the program, right? Yes. Again, good afternoon and welcome. I would like to recognize the following individuals or groups of individuals who are in attendance today. Dr. Postlewaite, Superintendent of Charleston County School District. Members of the CCSD Board of Trustees, represented by Reverend Dr. Eric Mack, the current chairman of the board. Current members of our James Island Constituent School Board. City of Folly Beach, Mayor Tim Goodwin. Town of James Island, Mayor Bill Woolsey. Members of the District 3 Task Force. Members of the School Naming Committee. Members of the current Camp Road Middle School School Improvement Council. Members of the current Camp Road Middle School PTO. Members of the CCSD Cabinet. District 3 Principals. The Office of Strategies and Communication. The Office of Capital Projects, Rosenblum Co. Architectural Firm, Construction Management Firm Cumming, TQ Construction Company, parents and community members. So it was 2 years ago, December the 8th, 2018 to be exact, Many of us stood under a huge white tent on this site for the Camp Road Middle School groundbreaking ceremony. Also, it was a little over 6 years ago, November the 4th, 2014, Election Day, that the citizens of Charleston County overwhelmingly voted yes to continue the Charleston County Education Sales and Use Tax Referendum to help fund building projects for the 2016-2022 building phase. A new Fort Johnson Middle School was one of 35 projects listed on the referendum. A community task force was developed in January 2015 to create the vision for this project and to answer the question, what does a new Fort Johnson Middle School mean? The task force was represented by the island's feeder school principals, a member of each school's PTA, PTO, SIC, and faculty, as well as representatives from the James Island Constituent School Board. The task force had to look at data and answer some tough questions, the biggest one being, do we want one middle school on James Island to have a new state-of-the-art building while the other middle school still inhabits its facility, which too is aging? There were some tough, thoughtful discussions and information sessions with various guest speakers, and the task force developed the vision of merging the two former middle schools, Fort Johnson Middle School and James Island Middle School, into one middle school and building a single middle school for all students on James Island. From there, this vision was taken out on the road to various PTA meetings and community meetings on the island. The end result was, beginning in the 2017-2018 school year, we became one middle school with a new name, Camp Road Middle School, a new mascot, the Cougars, and new school colors, royal blue and silver. For 3 years, 2017 to 2020, we would exist as a new student body of 790 students in our transition space, the old James Island Middle School. Now the results of that task force's vision and hard work is before us today, and my apologies to Jeff Borori, the COO, if I'm stealing any of his thunder. We have one middle school on the island, as you heard, with 137,000 square feet, less square footage than the prior two middle schools, thus a cost savings measure. It's a state-of-the-art facility providing equal access and opportunity for all middle school students on James Island. We were able to build a two-story facility on the footprint of the old old Fort Johnson Middle School single-story campus, thus preserving the green space on the back of the campus for our students during school hours and our community after hours and on the weekend. This campus boasts of a 9,500 square foot gym suitable to seat the entire student body when we get back to normal. A 7,000 square foot cafeteria, both suitable for community use after hours. The building also includes 9 fully equipped science labs of approximately 1,200 square feet, 800 square foot classrooms, 2 computer labs, a makerspace lab, hallways that are 10 to 16 feet wide throughout the building, hallway collaboration stations, ample office space, and the most breathtaking peaceful spot on our campus, the Media Center. As a result of the merger, all students now have the opportunity to participate in additional programs, which include a comprehensive fine arts program, a Project Lead the Way curriculum, which includes design and modeling, robotics and automation, and marine science, as well as 2 foreign language options. This incredible faculty, the generous parents, the supportive island business community, and this beautiful building have placed Camp Road Middle School on the list of one of the best middle schools in the state. Thank you to everyone here today and those who will view this later for making this all possible.
Thank you, Principal Randall, for having me. It's a great day to be finally dedicating this new building. It's been a long time it's been built, but every day as it's gotten bigger and improved, we've been looking forward to the welcoming everyone here in the community. I wish that we weren't having this during the time of COVID and that we could do something a little different, but still, it's a great day. When Mr. Parler, when I asked Mr. Parler about this idea about combining our two middle schools to one, I gotta admit, I was skeptical, but he explained the reasoning that we would be able to have more programs to serve the people in our community, and that it really would reunite James Islanders and Folly Beachers in a way that hadn't been when we had our two middle schools. And I was convinced and have always supported this move, and I think it's been a great success. Certainly the facility is beautiful. Now, we in the town of James Island like to support all the schools on James Island, but one thing that maybe you aren't aware of, that this is the only school that's actually under town jurisdiction. I certainly hope that the red tape wasn't too bad as we went through the process of constructing it. In any case, I just want to share with Ms. Randall, please, if there's anything that your town government can do to help you, let us know. Thank you very much.
Well, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Tim Goodwin. I'm the mayor at Folly Beach. And this is also the school that our children and grandchildren attend. And thank you, Mr. Parler, and everybody that had anything to do with this school being built and combined. For my grandchildren and the grandchildren of everybody else in this community, thank you, thank you, thank you. Because this is truly a true state-of-the-art building. I wish that I had it when I was in school. I might have learned something a little bit better and probably wouldn't have went to the Citadel, I went to a higher place of education, right, Bill? But going through the program this morning, I got reminded of something that I talked to my council about the other day, and I would encourage each of you to go home and look up on YouTube, and it's Red Skelton's explanation of the Pledge of Allegiance. And it comes all the way from when he was a young boy and a teacher taught them. It's worth looking up, and it's worth remembering as you go forward. The next time you stand up, it's not just something you say out of rote motion. It's something that you really remember and what the words mean to you and to the students. And the students here, maybe they can all see it one time in the media center and learn something from it. But I want to say thank you again for allowing me to be here. It's been a great time. 2 years ago seems like it was just yesterday. It doesn't seem like it's been 2 years since we was under that tent, but I'm glad it's here, and I'm sure the rest of the community is equally as glad it's here. Thank you very much. And now I'll turn the program over to Dr. Reverend Back.
Good afternoon. I am Reverend Mack, chairman of the Charleston County School Board, and I have the honor of helping Camp Road Middle School dedicate the Media Center, which has been named for an esteemed gentleman, Mr. J. Arthur Brown. And before we dedicate the Media Center, let me tell you a little bit about Mr. Brown. J. Arthur Brown was born in Charleston, South Carolina in 1914, where he grew up and went to school. And after graduating from Avery Institute in 1932, he continued his education at South Carolina State College in Orangeburg, South Carolina, graduating in 1937. Mr. Brown moved back to Charleston, where he became a businessman, working as a real estate and insurance broker. And as a businessman in Charleston, he became affiliated with the local chapter of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. Brown worked his way to becoming the president of the Charleston chapter of the NAACP in 1955. And as president of the local chapter of the NAACP, Mr. Brown led a concerted effort to fight segregation in the public sphere. And through his work in the African American civil rights movement, Mr. Brown became president of the South Carolina Conference of the NAACP. His accomplishment as president included the desegregation of Eddie Stowe State Park and others in the late 1950s, desegregation of the Charleston Municipal Golf Course in 1961, and desegregation of Charleston School District in 1963, and as well as organizer and leader of multiple social movements such as sit-ins and boycotts, as well as participating in crucial court cases throughout the state of South Carolina. And throughout his life, Mr. Brown spent time participating in and contributing to different projects and groups in the Charleston area that work towards bettering the community, such as Humane Friendly Society Cemetery, Charleston Area Community Relations Committee, the Charleston Business and Professional Men's Association, and others. Mr. Brown died on February 14, 1988. We would like to dedicate the J. Arthur Brown Media Center, and in honor of his accomplishment, I ask that you please join in with me with a round of applause as we dedicate the J. Arthur Brown Media Center. And at this time, it gives me a great honor, as always, wherever I go, and I'm so happy to have went before her, but our esteemed superintendent, Dr. Jarita Postlewaite, will come now with her remarks and dedication. Dr. Postlewaite.
Thank you, Reverend Mack. I have the delightful honor of starting the dedication of this facility that we're sitting in to a very special man. Someone who is a role model for everyone, a hero to all of us, someone whose values and behaviors are as congruent as any human being I've ever known, someone who is an accomplished person, a Renaissance man, a Renaissance person, if you will, someone to whom we give great honor today and with whom we will share memories of this place and the other places that he's worked for years and years to come. As the mayor mentioned, if it weren't for COVID-19, this place would be packed with standing room only for folks who've come to honor and remember our principal, our leader, David Parler. I'll say a bit more in just a few moments, but at this time I'd like Ms. Boughton to start making her way to the stage. She has some very special remarks to make. We felt it was only appropriate that someone who has worked directly with Mr. Parler have the honor of sharing some of her reflections and pointing out for all of us what a remarkable human being has walked among us, has created an environment, a culture of respect and honor and dignity and accomplishment, whose amazing vision saw this place and created this opportunity. Ms. Boughton.
Thank you, Joe Williams. I did not know I was doing this. I did not dress for this, although maybe I did. I sure would have used a bigger font had I known that I was the one that was going to be reading this. Mr. Parler asked me to write his bio. We just heard the lovely other bio of Reverend Brown, Dr. Brown, excuse me, and he said it could have some fun in it. So I wrote it. Apparently everybody was too chicken to read it, and they handed it to me. So here it goes. And I have not practiced this. I really just got handed this. Friends, campers, islanders, we come to honor Parler, not to bury him. The good he's done is evident. The details are amazing. So that was a big Shakespearean intro to the dedication of the Camp Road Middle School Gymnasium to David A. Parler. It's also a reference to the CCSD policy that you gotta be dead to have a building named after you. So those of us who recognize and celebrate Mr. Parler's contributions to James Allen Middle School students are happy to have Principal Parler, AKA Thanos Parler, and so many more nicknames, alive and well here with us this evening to name the gym in his honor. But I must warn you that there are many different David Parlers. There's the athlete. Many know Mr. P from his national swim team achievements, or from his triathlon competitions, or from his annual run for Niger 5K, or his F3 exercise group, or from his dragon boat wins. There's also P-Man the Talent, with a capital T. Many know him as a gifted singer in his James Island Presbyterian Church choir and the prestigious Charleston Men's Chorus. Many know P. Diddy as a committed community member who has been recognized by the town of James Island as the 2018 Community Hero, who has hosted Arbor Day events and planted trees, and has been a supporter of the Island Mentoring Group. But folks, we haven't even started to know David A. Parler. It just so happens, before Mr. Parler came to our island's middle schools, he had a nearly 20-year life as a teacher, administrator, coach, and more west of the Ashley. From 1982 to 2001, Mr. Parler worked in St. Andrews and Middleton High Schools as a biology and physical science teacher, cross-country coach, tennis coach, junior Civitan club advisor, community school director, assistant principal, interim middle school, high school principal for 3 years. Yeah, those are some accomplishments, but really, what happens West Ashley stays West Ashley. Here on James Island, David Parler has contributed even more energy, involvement, and dedication to our middle schools. Mr. Parler was hired as principal at Fort Johnson Middle School in 2001, where he served for 16 years. In 2015, when Fort Johnson was slated for a new school, he recognized the opportunity to merge the two middle schools on the island. He knew there was already a divide between the two island middle schools and decided to take the hard road, Camp Road, by the way, to work to create a state-of-the-art middle school for all island students. It wasn't an easy process, but as he does with every task, David Parler shepherded the transition, attuned to every detail, and made it happen. And David Parler has created a middle school with more than just a beautiful campus and an outstanding academic record. He has supported the arts in our schools wholeheartedly. The Art Club just won another blue ribbon in the annual Festival of Lights postcard competition. He's fostered a music program, band, strings, and chorus, that is one of the top in our school district. He supported the James Island Players and gave them a home, and his time and talents. In their productions, he has played a preacher, a bartender, a gambler, a judge, a member of the presidential cabinet, and more. But wait, there's more. Principal P recognizes the value of a liberal arts education, and he's supported them. He's made sure that students would have the opportunity to learn French or Spanish, the only middle school in our district that offers both. He enthusiastically sponsored school visits by award-winning authors Kwame Alexander, Jennifer Nielsen, Adam Gidwitz, and too many more to name. More importantly, David Parler has given himself, his time, his attention, his heart to our James Island Middle School students. He attended middle school teams' games, volleyball, basketball, football, tennis, softball, baseball, soccer, swimming. He fostered the annual Quest teams, which have had individual and team winners every year. He created and supported the robotics team, our Scripps Spelling Bee program, honor roll assemblies, and Student of the Month breakfast. He led cheers and games at pep rallies and reindeer romps. But also take a minute to appreciate one of the small things Mr. P did every day for the students. He stood in the hallways at class changes, recognizing students by name and commenting on something important to each one. Spelling bee participant, football team accomplishment, region honor band student, junior scholar, anything, everything about each student. And the notes he writes, so many students and families cherish the gracious words he takes time to write. For the faculty, Dad is the principal every teacher hopes to serve under. He recognizes contributions teachers make, big as pulling off a huge school-wide career day, or Black History Month event, or small as filling in for a colleague who has had a family emergency. and the fun he brought to our schools. He hit the floor at PTO dances with teachers and students brave enough to do the bump. And he cut the rug at the annual eighth grade promotion dances until he got cold busted one year for using his moves on the dance floor. Busted by an eighth grade girl, his daughter Catherine. He was a frequent victim of the dunk tank for Fun Fridays, usually in a wetsuit, as kids took great fun in pelting the principal they knew and loved. But back to this gym, and really, this building. It's beyond amazing. It's state of the art, from the classroom furniture, the science labs, the treehouse library, and yes, this NCAA-worthy sports arena. P-Man guided every step of the design and build and furnish process. He'll be here watching games and plays and PE classes. His heart is here in this school community. So if you're blown away by this amazing building and gym and principal, please stand up and keep on standing to honor David Parley.
Thank you, everyone, and I think you can see why we thought that someone who had had the opportunity to work with Mr. Parler ought to be given the opportunity to deliver that remarkable and moving biography. So, Mr. Parler, the Honorable David Parler, we want to officially name this gymnasium after you. We ask that you come forward, Mrs. Parler and Catherine, if you'd like to come too. We are unveiling a replica of the bronze plaque that we placed outside this gym, and we'd like you to stand beside of it as we unveil it so that we can get a picture of you and your family by the bronze plaque. This, again, is a replica that you'll be able to take with you. The real one will be placed outside the door. So, that's the picture. Thank you, everyone, for joining in that celebratory moment, and congratulations again, Mr. Parler. We couldn't be prouder to be here with you and to celebrate with this moment. Thank you.
All right, so that's the act I've got to follow, huh? Well, first off, I'm Jeff Brody, I'm the Chief Operating Officer. I got duped into this coming here today. I thought this was the District 3 bus lot dedication. You want to talk about lack of equity in this district? We take care of everybody but my old buses. That's the only problem we got. So, and yes, you did steal my thunder, David, but you deserve to steal my thunder. You really do. And I might end up repeating a few comments. You know, I know that the leadership team has been recognized, but David Parler and Andy Westergaard, who were here when I began talking to him about moving out and being part of that combination, they were the ones that were responsible for bringing these schools together, shoehorning them into the old James Island Middle campus, and then having that team march here full steam on opening day when we really cut it pretty close to get into this facility. Before we knocked down the old school, David and I walked the old campus, and he pointed out a lot of things that he wanted to have done in this facility, and we ended in that old gym, and he said, I need to have something like this. That was the last day that we walked that campus together before we demoed it. And then on his last day of school here in the new building, we walked the campus again. And the last thing, and I'll never forget this, which is really representative of your attention to detail and how much you care. We finished our tour back there, the old track. We were walking down the walkway here, and he's given me his final marching orders, knowing that his time was short. And he walked away from me, and he just went walking into the pine straw. I'm like, oh boy. And he bent over and he pulled out a couple of weeds. I'm like, that's the attention to detail to make sure that this school was exactly the way he wanted it. Piggybacking on some of his comments, the fact that the school leaders, the faculty, and the families in this area trusted the district and the school to bring these two schools together was huge. It does give this entire area one middle school, and it does give everyone the same opportunity. With that consolidation, we're able to offer more in a school like this. And when, you know, David mentioned that this footprint is actually smaller than the old two schools combined, you'd hardly believe that when you do see the size of the big box spaces and those exploratory rooms and the hallways. But that reduction in footprint, despite having a great facility, saved us capital construction money that we could move to other buildings to spread the joy across the district. But it also represents an annual savings in operating costs by having 17,000 less square footage. You know, that's 2,000 square foot homes, a little less than that. But pretty close to that. That's kind of a nice thing to have. The last thing I'll say about David is when I got here, those of you might not know, we have one retired principal on our staff in Capitol. And at the time that I got here, it was Mr. Walt Pusey, who had been a longtime principal. And the first thing I said to Walt when I got here was, you know, you need to be thinking about the succession plan. When you're going to walk out the door, I want to know who you want to come in behind you. I did not have to say, I stopped right there and he just said, David Parler. Didn't think about it, didn't give me a list of principals' names, he just said David Parler. And I've been working on David Parler since then, about coming to work in Capitol, and so far my attempts to recruit have failed. But maybe someday you'll come back. It's that breadth of knowledge that he has beyond just looking at the scope of a facility and the school within it. He has that big picture. And that's something we're always looking for in Capitol. So I was up here for a big reason. That's to thank the amazing the facilities team, the builders, the designers that have been part of this process along the way that made it happen. These accomplishments occurred during a global pandemic. Among them that worked on this beautiful facility during the crisis include Cumming Management Group, Winchester Xavier and Associates, Rosenblum Combe Architects, Owens and Associates, Hussey Gay Bell, ADC Engineering, and TQ Constructors. I would like to call out Steve Coe. Steve, if you can stand for me up there, please. Thank you, Steve. Steve served as the lead architect and really went the extra mile. The selected site was challenged with concurrent planned road improvements, which aren't complete yet. We're getting there, out there on Camp Road. But Steve worked through those challenges, as well as that campus circulation plan to get cars and buses in and out of here. He had formed a great relationship with David Parler. That's always an essential part of the building process, is having the principal and designer on the same sheet of music, and Steve was a big part of that. The cantilever corner, we talk about the treehouse library, that unique feature will serve as a community landmark for years to come. From Cumming Construction Management Group, we got Rick Colt, Richard Coppola, Joe Christian, Jack Wayne, the four of you guys, all four of you are up there. They brought this, they stepped up here at the end, driving this project in the final weeks of construction, and instrumental in getting the certificate of occupancy from the state and saving the track record of our entire program since 2000 of being on time, on budget, and within scope. Our CCSD teammates in finance, procurement, information technology, security, and emergency management, and facilities management once again provided that all-pro special teams play. Please give every one of those individuals and teams a round of applause. Thank you. Next up, Dr. George Temple, Vice Chair for Constituent District 3.
Good evening, and thank you for this opportunity. This is a marvelous facility, made even better by the faculty that are here and the administrators, Sharon, for example. I might also note, as I ask you to stand, that both of my sons graduated from Camp Road Middle. So would you please stand? To properly guide and direct the youth of our community to a full concept of life, mentally, spiritually, and physically.
We dedicate this school
for the understanding of the necessity to live in peace and to train our youth in the importance of mutual acceptance.
We dedicate this school
to the development of the whole person, the broadening of knowledge, the development of skills, and the enrichment of personality and character.
We dedicate this school to this cause, and we will strive to be worthy examples for our children to follow.
To the training of citizenship that will lead to safe, clean, and wholesome community life, enriched by service and acquaintance with one's fellow man.
We dedicate this building and pledge ourselves to cooperate with the school officials to the realization of this goal.
To realize that each student is different in ability and skills, to accept the fact that there are varied ethical and moral backgrounds, to present truth to the student, thus permitting them to learn in an environment that fosters collaboration, cooperation, and participation that is conducive for all.
We dedicate this school.
Thank you.
So I fall in the end of the day. So, great evening, everyone. How are you all? Good. So I'd be remiss if I did not say thank you again to BET, because I did put her on the spot. She was telling the truth, y'all. And like Dr. Postaway said, that's exactly why I did that, because no one could have read that as well as you did. Thank you. So with that being said, I always get the honor of closing out these events. Now, I don't know if I should take that as a compliment or not, but I always get asked to do this. But I do like to close out these events because, number one, I get to keep it short and sweet. And number two, I get to share a personal story about the school or the person that I'm talking about. So with that being said, when I was appointed to my position at the district office, hearing a story about David Pollard and his school was like hearing a tall tale. Seriously. It was like the hallways are lined in gold. It always smells like fresh baked cookies. All the mirrors reflect your ideal body. So I had to come over here and visit when it was Fort Johnson and just see what the school was about. And I'll be honest with you, it was like a tall tale when I got here, because as I walked with David in his school, he's a man of small stature, but it was like walking with a giant as we walked through his foyer area, because all I could see was all these flags that said excellent, excellent, excellent. And I was really impressed by that. But what impressed me even more is when we left that area and we walked out into the courtyard. And I don't know if David remembers this, but all I remember was seeing all this lush vegetation, flowers, potted plants, flower beds. And I said, my goodness, David, this is amazing. This is beautiful. It feels welcoming. It feels warm. And David said, yes, we put a lot of hard work into this, but unfortunately, it'll be gone soon. And as I thought about that, I said, wow, what a waste that they've done all of this hard work as a family and it'll be gone. And then the light bulb went off. That's when I realized that we were going to be okay with the merger, because what had happened here would happen at James Island when you converted to make that Camp Road, and you'd also bring it over here when you came into the new building. So I want to challenge you all to continue with that family feeling that you've established here on James Island, because I'm going to be very honest and transparent. It's very evident when you come over here. It was evident the first day I came over here, David, and that was a testament of your leadership. And I know it's going to be evident as you all continue on sharing. So be proud of that. You should be, and I am honored and grateful to be here tonight to dedicate this school, which is long overdue, so give yourselves a big round of applause for that. Thank you to everyone for coming here on this evening, and I want to say thank you so much to the adults that work with the scholars. That was amazing and beautiful. The ones that came up here and did the Pledge of Allegiance, and also the ones that sang today, round of applause for them. And I also want to close by saying that, David, in addition to the foyer area and in addition to the nice flowers and everything you had, it did smell like fresh baked cookies, and the mirrors did reflect my ideal body. So thank you for that as well. Thank you all so much. Have a great evening.